Hello. We're back.
Welcome to Gab and Jam, episode 49.
49. So we did 48, and it is 49. So, and these two are meant to kind of be watched together as with all the other past 47. So just remember that, okay?
Okay, so our topic today, which we think is extremely relevant, I've seen this question some of everywhere on music blogs, and I've heard it discussed on some of the shows we listen to. Are albums in this day and age irrelevant?
That's a good question. And I think that the artists of today have got a healthy attitude when it comes to albums.
Okay,
so,
what do you mean?
I think you had kind of brought this up before, but it's sort of like when you're thinking about a concept album, let's just take Beyonce's Lemonade.
Mm-hmm.
She dropped it all at once. Mm-hmm. She dropped it, you know, and it was a surprise, but you got the whole thing.
Mm-hmm.
You got that plus videos, mm-hmm. everything that tied the whole thing together. So you, conceptually, you mm-hmm. got the whole concept, right? And then we have other artists who kind of do like these one-off singles, mm-hmm. right?
Like Kanye West did that. We know, I think Chance the Rapper did it. Yeah. Ariana Grande kind of does it every now and again.
Yeah, she kind of did it, but then she dropped the album too. But, you know, it's arguably more or less an album of singles,
mm-hmm.
right?
Right?
That she kind of really dropped. And so I think in some ways it is dead, and I don't think it's necessarily a bad thing. So
okay,
meaning
what
that,
do you mean?
That people forget that, you know, a long time ago, like with the Beatles and the rest of that, right? And when the Beatles first started, Beatles did I Wanna Hold Your Hand. They did. Mm-hmm. And they're really a singles-based band.
So the songs were meant to be enjoyed individually.
That's the way that they were meant to be. They were good pop songs mm-hmm. that were meant to be enjoyed that way.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, same thing with Motown. Motown mm-hmm. was more singles when it was going.
Mm-hmm.
And we look back fondly on that music.
Yeah.
We don't feel like that music was just, you know, toss away type of music. I mean, but that's what it was meant to be. It was meant,
mm-hmm.
they were meant to be pop songs,
mm-hmm.
meant to stay on the charts for 3, you know, months, whatever, and then you come out with another one.
Mm-hmm.
Right, so in a way, to me, that's nothing new.
We've
been here before.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, only when we got to the 70s
mm-hmm.
and you started getting, you know, rock groups, especially coming up with these concept records.
Right,
or
even, you need to enjoy it. You need, each song made a statement within
And let me not do it that way. Let's back up.
Okay.
Because really, we can say it started with the Beatles.
Okay.
And with, the Beach Boys.
Okay.
Pet Sounds.
Okay.
You think about Sgt. Pepper.
Okay,
you
right.
You think about those records, Revolver. These were records that were more conceptual
mm-hmm.
and less singles
okay.
kind of
mm-hmm.
minded in a way, you know. So we were meant to be enjoyed as a whole
mm-hmm.
as opposed to really looking at them as just singles that were mm-hmm. meant to go on the top of the pop charts. And then once you get into a group like Led Zeppelin,
mm-hmm.
you know, using the longest saying, hey, we're not going to release Stairway to Heaven as a
wow.
single, not looking to do that, and you know, and having their fourth album where, you know, there's no title to that. It's just the fourth album. You know, people call it Zozo. They call it whatever else. But it's really an untitled record.
Mm-hmm.
So it was really meant. They always put out these opuses or,
mm-hmm.
you know, Rush with 2112. You know,
okay.
I mean, it's 20 minutes.
Oh, wow.
You know, the song is. And they did Hemispheres, another 20 minutes on one side.
Wow.
You know, so. These were albums that were meant to be enjoyed as albums,
mm-hmm.
and we're just not at that space
mm-hmm.
anymore.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we're at a space now where actually people want different things,
mm-hmm.
and artists serve different purposes with their career.
Mm-hmm.
And so,
people's attention span is a lot less.
To some extent, until you find your audience. You know, once
right.
you find
yeah.
your audience, your crew. And then they will do the deep dive.
Yeah,
with
we
you.
Talked about that before. How
right?
How I once I find somebody and I really like what I think I like what they do from that one song.
Right.
I go back and try to find everything.
Right.
And it's disconcerting for me when I find out that that's just the one song that sounds like that, or the one song that gives me that piece right. you know, that flavor.
Right.
So for me, I kind of like to go back and find it as part of a body of work. However, right. for other people, it must not be an issue.
No, I agree. And I take Janelle Monáe's record. Mm-hmm. I think that her record is more of a conceptual piece. Okay. It's like, you know, as I listen to a whole record, it's really a whole concept album that works better if you hear it all together. Mm-hmm. I don't think she necessarily has a lot of singles mm-hmm. on that record. It's mm-hmm. that's not the type of artist she is. I mean, she's a little bit different from Lauryn Hill, and Lauryn Hill's record was, okay. again, that was more of a conceptual mm-hmm. record mm-hmm. that just happened to have singles, but it was definitely not some singles-laden record, mm-hmm. you know? Whereas I think Michael Jackson's albums are probably a little bit less conceptual, mm-hmm. you know, and more geared towards going to the top of the pop charts, you know, whereas Prince's albums were more conceptual, mm-hmm. you know, and again, it's not to say one is better than the other mm-hmm. as much as both are meant to serve different purposes.
Okay.
You know, and so I think that the artists of today have been wise enough to see this, mm-hmm. that you have an audience that will consume things, mm-hmm. you know, as quickly as you put it out.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And maybe, too, they can do them both, you know, meaning mm-hmm. that they kind of let you hear these records right. as they come out and then allow you to kind of say, hey, look, this is the whole package.
Yeah.
You know, when it's done.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's just a whole different concept.
A launch ahead of time kind of excites you, gets you ready
right.
for the entire album. So when they drop the album, you definitely want to get
the whole thing. Yeah, you want the whole thing and you want to hear the whole thing together. And then you can decide how you mm-hmm. kind of, it's kind of like choose your own adventure type of thing.
Yeah.
You know, but again, I don't think it's a good idea or a good way to look at it as the album dying, because mm-hmm. I think that almost has more of a negative connotation mm-hmm. to it. Maybe we should say, has the album and the whole concept of an album evolved?
Okay.
You know, are we going to the next step, the next phase as to where this industry is taking us to?
And like we talked about before, back with Steal My Stuff and some of the other episodes, right. things are a lot more flexible now.
Yeah, they are.
That as artists, again, you get to choose right. the way you want to shape your message and the way you want to, you know, communicate with your fans and figure out what your fans want.
Right. It's like the part that's really strange is that, you know, I think they're doing like a re-release of Prince's, I think, 3121, Musicology, and Planet Earth.
Oh.
They're redoing them, and they're doing them on vinyl.
Oh, wow.
So at the same token, while we're asking the question, is the album dead? Mm-hmm. We're seeing a resurgence of vinyl and cassette.
Yes.
You know, which for me, I don't understand what cassettes. They're awful. They sound horrible.
It's a nostalgic thing.
It might be, but they sound horrible. Yeah. They have always sounded horrible, and I will always say that.
For people who never heard them, it's one of those kind of things that I think.
Yeah, they're not missing anything.
But they don't know that. They got to figure that out.
Worse than your MP3s. If you think your MP3s sound bad, cassettes sound worse than that. Now, maybe mm-hmm. you could say with vinyl brings a little bit more character. I mean, they definitely had a higher sound quality. Mm-hmm. Than cassettes did, but cassettes were a necessary evil.
Yeah, and then vinyl brings the artwork back.
Right.
So that was something that has been, you know, people have been saying have been missing for years.
Right.
It's part of getting into the album is having the larger piece of art that connects to the whole project. So
I mean, you know, when you had to choose between an A-track and a cassette, the cassette was the best viable option
because
you could kind of fast forward to your next tune mm-hmm. instead of having to punch through different tracks, try to time out. Okay,
they don't know nothing
about
it.
The track four, I had to go. No, that was horrible.
It was pretty
awful.
Bad.
It was the worst.
Yeah.
So no, cassettes are awful. Yeah. Don't go back to them. Don't go back to a bad thing. It's horrible.
Well, they got to see that for themselves.
Yeah.
It's like raising kids.
I can
tell them all you want to, but they got to figure it out for themselves. So what do you guys think?
Yeah.
Do you think the album is irrelevant, or do you think it has evolved? What do you think? We want to hear. Drop what you think in the comments below. Also, let you know what's coming up. We have South by Southwest meetup. What's going to happen at our South by Southwest?
South by Southwest. Southwest.
South by Southwest meetup
mm-hmm. is going to be some of everything. Mm-hmm. We're going to be doing busking. We're going to yep. be going to music stores. Mm-hmm. We're going to be doing meetups.
Yes.
We're going to be going to all of the great events that they have around mm-hmm. there, looking to network, mm-hmm. looking to just take it all in.
And
so
blog. We'll be sharing all that stuff.
We're going to be sharing with you guys. So, I mean, I think it's try to do that daily.
Yes.
You know, get something
out. It's going to be a challenge, but we're going to meet that challenge.
It is. And, mm-hmm. and you know what? You know, regardless of how I'm feeling that day, whatever's going on, we're going to do it.
Okay.
It's going to be just open and honest. Okay? So, look out for that.
Okay.
We're definitely looking to do that. And then we also have Gearfest 2019. Mm-hmm. We're doing basically kind of the same stuff.
Mm-hmm.
You know, meeting up, you know, jamming.
Yeah,
whatever it is,
session,
right?
Yep, yep.
Whatever happens, you know, we'll see. We'll play it by ear, make it happen. And then London,
yep.
we'll be doing that 2019 again.
In the fall, yep.
Same mm-hmm. old, same thing. We're going to be trying to meet up with folk that we know there,
yeah.
going to music stores, jamming, whatever. So all that stuff is gonna be a great and fun 2019. We'll do all kinds of crazy wild stuff.
If
so.
You want us to save you a spot, because you know you don't want to miss out, we will have prizes, all kinds of little giveaways. Make sure you click the link below and sign up so that you can get notified about all the details as they take shape. And if you would like show notes and to find out about former topics in case you missed some of the other 40-something episodes of Gab and Jam, make sure you go to www.bloomandprejippie.com/subscribe so that you can get show notes and you can hear about the old topics as well as new upcoming topics.
Yeah.
Also, you can suggest topics. We're always open to see what you want to hear about.
Throw a link down at the bottom or something.
Yep,
like
I love it.
Stuff, okay?
Okay, I love it.
So you can just go ahead and click around and
mm-hmm.
enjoy all the different stuff you want to enjoy. And again, this is not meant to be us just talking to the camera,
yeah.
talking to you guys, as much as it's meant to be us beginning a discussion.
I love it.
So we want you all to
mm-hmm.
give us your comments. Tell us what you think. You know, we want to hear it, you know,
mm-hmm.
and you know, we'll look to respond to it.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, again, that's what it's meant to do. It's meant to create this conversation
mm-hmm.
amongst creative people, or
mm-hmm.
however you do it, whether you're doing music,
yep.
whether you're listening to music, wherever you fall at
yep.
on the spectrum, we want to hear from you.
Yeah.
Yep.
If you dig the vibe, make sure you
subscribe.
Love, peace, and
chicken grease.
Yay.